Christmas is a wonderful time for a lot of different reasons. One of the reasons that I love Christmas is we all get to be a little bit like children again. And for children, Christmas is a time of surprise and a time of mystery. Although, to be honest, for myself, when I was a child, most of the surprise and mystery hinged around which packages have my name on them and what's inside those packages. As adults, we start to lose some of that surprise and some of that mystery. After all, we bought most of those packages and wrapped them ourselves. Or as another example, when you got up this morning, you probably could have guessed relatively closely which carols we would be singing tonight. When you got in your car to come here, you probably could have guessed roughly which Bible passages we would be reading. In fact, I probably could have asked you on the way out of last year's Christmas Eve service what my sermon was likely to be about tonight, and you probably could have made a pretty good guess. Because if you've been paying attention, there's not a whole lot of surprise in that, right? There's not a great deal of mystery to it, right? Well, actually, to that last statement, I would say absolutely wrong. And the more you've been paying attention, the more you realize what a mystery Christmas is. In fact, I would say that tonight is the most mysterious night out of the entire year. Because tonight is the night that we remember that an infinite God became an infant boy. How is that possible? I don't know. Tonight is the night that we remember that the creator of all that exists became a part of his own creation. And I do not know how. Tonight is the night that we remember that the God on whom all of human history depends became in human history a dependent. And I don't know how. The more you reflect on it, the more times I reflect on it, the mystery only grows. I told you before the prelude to pay attention to some of the words that Danielle was singing for us in that song, Mary, Did You Know? As it asked that whole series of questions. Did you know that your son would one day walk on water? Did you know that he would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy was born to set this world free? I said I would talk about it again, because if you know the biblical passages, then you know that the answer to many of those questions is a resounding yes. She did know that. Why did she know it? Because the angel had announced it to her. And in case she had missed it, the angel had announced it to Joseph as well. And on that first Christmas night, the angel announced it to the shepherds, and they reminded her of it. 8 days later, when they dedicated Jesus, the prophet and the prophetess reminded her again. She knew that this Jesus, well, first she knew that it would be a boy. She knew that the boy would be named Jesus. She knew that he would be called the Son of the Most High God. She knew that he had come to save the people from their sins. She knew all of that. Do you think it made it any less of a mystery how that could be? I mean, she carried that baby boy to a full-term pregnancy just like any other pregnancy. It had started quite a bit differently, but the rest of it was pretty much the same. And when that baby was born, he was born in the normal way, the only exception being that perhaps his circumstances were even more humble than most babies' circumstances. She knew the data. She wasn't going to be surprised by any of it. And yet it was a tremendous mystery. How could God be doing what he was doing? I don't know. Neither did she, neither did Joseph, neither did anybody, but they knew that he was doing it. The mystery was in how. But I'll tell you something that is most definitely not a mystery this Christmas Eve. It is a mystery how an infinite creator God on whom all of human history depended could become an infant, part of his own creation, a dependent within human history. That's a mystery, the how. What's not a mystery is why. God makes very plain to us why he was doing what he was doing in that first Christmas manger. God made very plain to us why an infinite creator on whom all of human history depended was becoming an infant creation in part of human history. And we read it in the passage that Bud read for us from 1 John chapter 4, verse 9, where we read, "In this the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him." How God did what he did at Christmas, I do not know. And no matter how long I live and no matter how many times I read the passages, I don't think I will ever get to the bottom of that particular mystery. I will never be able to answer fully, to my own satisfaction or yours, how. But I can answer fully, and so can you, why. God did it because he loved you. That's why he became human. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. And how can that be? If we continue reading, "In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent us his Son to be the redemption price for our sins." If we've been to Christmas Eve services before, there's not a whole lot of surprise what we're going to sing and what we're going to read and even what I'm going to preach about. But that does not in any way diminish the mystery of what God was doing. How it could happen, I will never be able to explain. But I'll spend the rest of my life rejoicing and proclaiming, and I hope you will do the same. Spend the rest of your life rejoicing and proclaiming why God did it. God did it because that's how great his love was for you and for me and for the whole sinful world, that he was willing to become a human and to take on our flesh and to live the sinless life that we could never successfully live and to die the sinner's death that we could never have survived and to rise again triumphant over sin and death and the grave. I'm giving away some spoilers here if you're planning on coming at Easter. The reality is, that's what God was doing. How he did it, we'll never be able to understand, but we will know and rejoice and proclaim with every ounce of our being and with every word that we speak and with everything that he calls us to do. We will pronounce and rejoice why he did it. This is how much God loved you, and God loved me, and God loved the whole sinful world, that he was willing to enter it. An infant, helpless, dependent part of creation, to take on sin, to conquer sin, and to give us life. And that's exactly what had been promised to Joseph. When the angel said to him, "Do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." And may we enjoy and reflect on and proclaim the mystery of Christmas every day. May the peace of God that passes all understanding guard your hearts and minds firmly in Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior. Amen.